In this video, we're going to show how to do a basic RTK survey. For that, we're going to create a new job. Give it a name. And select our coordinate system. Now, by default, your controller should already have a template with this setting predefined. But in this case, I'm going to go through all of the individual settings, selecting our shift grid file and our geoid model file. Also, making sure our coordinate order is set to easings, northings, and elevations. I'm going to accept this. And we can start to measure. RTK measure points. This video guide assumes that we already have our base station already started and transmitting, and it's valid for either radio operation or RTK operation. Now, in the measure point screen, we have a few different methods of measuring points. The default one is topo point. We have a few others there. All of them have individual option settings. This auto start point means that we only need to click once to start the point. And we have this auto tolerance box that we can leave ticked or unticked. If we unticked it, we can actually set our accuracy, desired accuracy per point. It will act as a threshold. So now start one point. We can type in our code if we want to. And now with auto store point, we only need to press once and the point will be automatically stored. If we go into our observed control point, we see there's actually a different naming for the point. But we have the same type of options to change. Main difference being we have 180 epochs of observation per observed control point. For measuring codes, we have a nice little feature called measure codes. In this screen, if you follow the instructions, for starters, you need to add a group of codes. I'm just going to name it quick codes. Okay, and we'll have a 3x3 checkers board, which you need to define with some codes. For that, you'll just press and hold one of the boxes, let go, so you can have this nice little screen, so you can type in your code or get it from the arrow from within your own feature library. I'll just type in some basic codes here. Now, whenever you press one of these buttons, it will automatically populate the code with the one that's written on the icon. You can always also use your numeric keyboard on your TSE3 to access these 9 points. So 1 through 9 matches the same positions as this checkerboard. If you want some more codes, you can just add another group. Now, for a different option, if you go into our map, we can visually check every point we measure so far. And we can see here our base station symbol, which I don't want to see, so I'm just going to my filter and untick the base points. And now when I do zoom extents, the point is still there, it's just not visible anymore. Now, with one point selected, I have some options available on my active map. This one allows me to review the point details. The way to check it is to select a point, long press on the white part of the screen. It will give you some options. With two points, I have additional options, like sticking out line like computing inverse. We clear the selection with option, and if I select 3 points, I can key in an arc, I can do area calculations, I can create a surface, or I can compute a volume. So the active map allows you to access different functions depending on the number of points you have selected. You can also stake out a point straight away from your map if selected. Another useful function would be the point manager, which you can access through your favorites menu. Point manager allows you to review a list of all your coordinates that you measure so far. Please check the elevation on point number 1, that's 51.268. You can review your antenna height, your easings and northings, and some other settings. On the display function, you have different views for your observations. For GNSS data, you can easily review your LUTs and launch for each individual point. And you can edit and add or change a code from it, as you can see. Now, some editing is available under the screen. You can edit codes, coordinates, nodes, and point names. The targets options it's grayed out because you need to set the display to display the targets first. If you go into options now, and you go and edit your targets, you can actually change the height of your pole. And if you go back to display, and remember we had 51.268, we now have 50. So it automatically updates your target heights, your levels.